Would you like your income accounts to reflect income from billed expense items to clients? Well, then you need to learn how to use two-sided expense items. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Two-sided items are also items that vendors provide for us and get placed on a check or a bill at the moment we purchase them. The item is attached to an expense type of account and also to an income type of account. That's what makes it a two-sided item. So why do we use two-sided items? Well, if you need to use expense items for the reasons that we spoke about in the prior video, you may want to track the income from billing them in an income account instead of a reduction of the expense account the way it was in the previous video. The only way to do that when using expense items is to use the two-sided items. So, let's imagine that this is what our items list looks like. It's very extensive here at the end of the course. And when we click for a new item, we get this window. And if you click the check mark here, it will become a two-sided item. That means the bottom of the window will open up and you will have a field for placing the income account for when we bill or sell, and also have a field for the expense account when we purchase the item. For example, you could have indoor job materials as a special contractor expense. Those expenses might be for window panes, they might be for brackets, they might be for sheetrock. We know that the indoor job materials would be an account in your chart of accounts as an expense, but the items themselves would be the detail of what you actually bought and you're actually billing the client for. So, each two-sided expense item needs the following. It needs an expense side where you connect it to an expense type of account and you input the purchase cost when you purchase. Then it needs an income side that you connect to an income type of account and you input the price that you charge or sell when you're billing the client. For example, let's add two accounts into the chart of accounts for this new thing called indoor job materials. Let's imagine that we have indoor job materials expense and indoor job materials income. We'll put them in the chart of accounts before we put the items. Very simple. List chart of accounts, account, new, expense, indoor job materials expense. You can pause the video if you're still typing it in and click save and new. Now we want the income account, indoor job materials income. And again, you can pause the video if you need to type it in. Save and close. Now our chart of accounts is ready with the accounts that we need. And now, let's go and put in the items. We will add two items to the items list. Sheetrock that we purchase for $3 each unit and sell to the client at $5 each unit. And brackets. We buy them for $4 each unit and we sell and bill them to the client at $10 each. Now, how are we going to do this? Once we put the items and the purchase cost and sales price, we will connect them both to the indoor job materials expense that we just created and the indoor job materials income account that we just created a second ago. The type must be non-inventory type And you must put the check mark where it says, this service is used in assemblies or performed by a subcontractor or partner. You must put that in order to get the two-sided item like I showed you a moment ago. So let's put in this first one here. We go list, item, new. Now it's a service, but you must click this check mark to make it a two-sided item. Now the first one will be sheetrock. And we will connect the, we purchase sheetrock for $3 each and sell it for $5 each. Cost, $3. Price, $5. Now, the expense account for sheetrock will be indoor job materials expense, and the income account for sheetrock will be indoor job materials income. And this is the way your first two-sided item would look like. When you click next, you're lucky that it will remember the two accounts, both for expense and income. So now we want brackets, buy for $4 and sell for $10. Okay, brackets. We purchase for $4 each unit and we sell for $10 each unit. Click OK. Now we have the items on the items list and we follow the instructions exactly as they're written, and now we're ready for our first transaction. Let's imagine on February 2nd, we purchased 7 units of sheetrock and 5 brackets. And these are the purchase costs that we bought it for, and that's what we already set up. 7 sheetrock and 5 brackets, and it's billable to the Lillian Court job under Brown Company. So what would be the money amount of this transaction? I happen to know 7 times 3 is 21, 5 times 4 is 20. So the amount would be $41 that we're purchasing this expense. So what would change in the trial balance at the moment we record purchasing this expense? Well, if we pay $41 for the first time for indoor job materials, then indoor job materials expense will show up for the first time as $41. And because the money came from cash and bank will decrease by $41 and become $8,018. So that will be the result, and let's go and check. Let's actually go ahead and record this transaction. We click banking, write a check, and the date was February 2nd. It comes from Chase Bank, and it's Home Depot as the vendor. And of course, if you don't see Home Depot on the list, what do? Add new, vendor, Home Depot. Enter, and now it's on the list. Now be careful. Do not put a money amount if you're dealing with items. Do not put anything in the expense tab if you're dealing with items. You have to click the items tab, then choose the items themselves. Now, when we click the sheetrock, click for the sheetrock, notice QuickBooks remembers the purchase cost that we buy it for, and the quantity of sheetrock would be 7 units. And of course, it's billable to Lillian Court under Brown Company. We're also buying brackets, and QuickBooks remembers that we buy them for $4 each. And in this example, we're buying 5 of them, and it's also billable to that specific job. So this is the way the check looks when you purchase. These could be 2 totally different clients that it's billable for. That would be fine as well. So now when we click Save and Close, we can open the trial balance, and the numbers are exactly as what we expected. Indoor job materials showed up for the first time as $41, and the cash and bank account went down to $8,018. Are we done checking the results after the trial balance? No. We must always check the profit and loss by client to make sure that Lily in court got billed the proper amount of indoor job materials expense, $41. Now, let's bill Brown Company for the Lily in court job materials that we just purchased. Let's imagine on February 5th, we billed Brown Company for the indoor job materials for the Lily in court job that we purchased on February 2nd. And we will charge him the amount that was already recorded, $5 a unit for sheetrock and $10 a unit per bracket. Now, what will happen in the trial balance at the moment we bill the client? I happen to know the total sales or billing price would be $85. That means that indoor job materials income will show up in the trial balance for the first time as $85. And because the client owes us that money and is responsible for it, accounts receivable will increase by $85 and become $125,041 at the moment we bill for this $85 invoice. What do we do? Well, it's very simple. We open the invoice window and we make the date February 5th in our little story. It's for the Lily in court job under Brown Company. We will not use the available estimate. Click cancel, because sometimes the reimbursable expenses are not part of the estimate. But what we have to do is select the outstanding billable times and costs. Now we click OK. Remember, there's nothing under expense this time. That was the way we did it earlier in the course. We have to click items, because now we're billing for items. Notice, because it's an invoice rather than an expense or check, it remembers the price rather than the cost. So we click both of these and click OK. And notice, because it's on an invoice rather than a check, when we wrote the check, it remembered each individual purchase cost for sheetrock and brackets. But now that it's on an invoice, it remembers the price that we put for sheetrock and brackets for this client on this date for this amount. Now, we remove the email later, and then, of course, we click Save and Close. And then when we check the trial balance, the results are exactly as what we expected. Indoor job materials income showed up for the first time as $85, and indoor job materials expense did not and should not change. So why? Well, first let's check the profit and loss by job. You can see under Lily in court, we have $85 more of income instead of losing this $41 in expense. This $41 in expense stays here after we purchase, because we're using two-sided items, and instead of disappearing the way it did with the one-sided item, it stays here, and the income, including the markup, shows up in the profit and loss by job in the income section for that client. So please understand, account settings are not relevant regarding billing for expense items or even two-sided items. The two-sided expense item, like we're doing here, will always increase the income account when you bill the client. The good news is you could mark up the expense by simply charging more on the invoice to the client than what you paid for on the check or the bill. Now, these settings, remember you click Edit, Preferences, and you go to the Expense tab and click this check mark. These settings are not relevant when you're dealing with items. So if you want the expense to reduce when you bill, you do what we learned in the previous video. You use a one-sided item. If you want to keep the expense and increase the income when you bill the client, you do what you learned here, the two-sided item.
You can learn everything you need in QuickBooks regarding contractor features by watching the full playlist that this video is a part of. You can just click the link in the comment field or under the first paragraph in the description field, and there's also links in the top right of the video as it plays.